Happy New Year, guys! I'm so sorry you got to see my face again in this video. I'm here to share a few words of gratitude for our last video. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for all the love and support we got for our last video. We are truly so happy to see the response. It was a very last minute video. We didn't even plan what to do. And I'm glad that you all liked it. We shot that video for almost 2 days. One day we shot churros and the other day we shot pizza with the same clothes and makeup. To not spoil the sequence and we edited it for almost 3 days. Whatever, we got a very good response. Thank you so much. We considered all your comments and feedback and we'll definitely try to not repeat the same mistakes in our next coming videos. So we thought of making a special video every month. Mostly next special video will be on the occasion of Sankranti. If you want to see more special videos in this channel, please comment in the comment section below. And without any further delay, let's start today's video.
Kobbari annam or coconut rice is an authentic South Indian dish. It's made up of coconut milk and it's prepared mostly on the days of festivals. For that, firstly, take a pan, add some ghee and fry few cashew nuts. After they are fried, take them into a plate and in the same pan, add 3 to 4 spoons of oil. Add Shah Jeera and other biryani spices like ilachi, cinnamon, cloves, etc. Now add chopped onions, green chilli and curry leaves. Let them fry for few minutes. Then add mint leaves and coriander leaves. Now add chopped tomatoes. And add some ginger garlic paste, some turmeric powder, it's optional. One spoon coriander powder. And salt according to your taste. Next, add few biryani leaves. Though this dish is made up of coconut milk, it doesn't taste sweet. It's more like a biryani, but coconut enhances the flavor of rice. Now it's time to add coconut milk. I'm using the store-bought one. So for 2 cups of rice, you can add 3 cups of coconut milk and 1 cup of water. Or directly you can add 4 cups of coconut milk, it's up to you. Make sure that it's not very sweet. You can also make it at home just like almond milk or you can directly get it from supermarket. Mix all the ingredients together and add fried cashews. Add some jeera powder. And when the water is sufficiently boiled, add rice. After adding rice, close the lid and let it cook for at least 15 to 20 minutes. And it's ready. The best combination with this rice is Andhra chicken curry. So now let's see how to make it. Firstly, take a pan, add 2 to 3 spoons of oil, add Shah Jeera. And let it fry. Next, add chopped onions, green chilies, and curry leaves. Next, add salt according to your taste. And pinch of turmeric powder. Let the onions fry till they become golden brown in color and then add ginger garlic paste. After the onions are completely fried, add 1 kilo of chicken. To get rid of stinking smell, you can wash chicken with salt and turmeric powder. Now keep the lid and let chicken cook for at least 20 minutes. After it's semi-cooked, add mint leaves. It's optional, but it gives a very good flavor to your curry. And again, close the lid. After the piece gets softened, add red chili powder according to your taste. Mix it. Add garam masala and again let it cook. Now add water according to your consistency and close the lid again. After the chicken is almost cooked, add chopped tomatoes. And finally, add some jeera powder and coriander leaves. Cook it on low flame for at least 10 minutes and you're done. Spicy Andhra Kodi Kura is ready. Serve it hot with your fam and enjoy this new year. Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, please subscribe to my channel. Comment your views and suggestions in the comment section below. I'll be up with another exciting video super soon. Thank you. Bye bye.